The graduation ceremony of our third batch since the opening of this campus in Bangkok. Welcome all, proud families, new students, old students, and also alumni that are joining us today online and on site. So, I am Shaima Erset. I'm standing in front of you guys today, not only as the master of the ceremony, but also as the head of marketing and admissions at Harbour.Space University, and also as a proud alumna of this institution that has witnessed a huge change throughout not even the years, but the months. I am here standing to share with you the accumulation of hard work of dedicated individuals who worked very hard throughout the year to produce projects that are innovative, creative, and impactful. So, as I want to start my speech today, I am reminded of a poet, very famous poet's quote, Rumi, when he says, "As you start to walk on the way appears." And this is the spirit of Harbour.Space University, where we believe that each step taken with determination and curiosity paves the way for new horizons of knowledge and innovation. So without further ado, I want you all to welcome our graduates this year and give them really a really warm round of applause. Let's go, graduates. Oh, they're shy. Graduates, can we get the graduates? It's your graduation. I don't see anyone. Oh, they just left. So today we will just celebrate us. Okay, I have the new students. If you want to graduate today, let's go. Okay, they're coming up. Let's go. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Looking nice and sharp. Let's go. Okay, so we have the quiet of the agenda today. I can walk you through it very quickly before we start. So, hello, 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 please have a seat. So, for today's agenda, it's divided to three main parts. First, we will go through our demos. Today, we will have 7 presentations for you, 5 startups and 2 portfolios. We will have the networking and a break, so you can talk to these students, ask them more about their projects, network with them, and get their contacts if you're interested in their projects or in them as individuals. And finally, we will have the graduation ceremony, where we will celebrate the accomplishment of each and every one of you today. Can I have, so today we have very, very interesting pick of presentations and individuals that worked really, really hard throughout the whole year to present you their project. As you can see here, we will have a mix. We have We Share with Earn, we have Design Portfolio with Picky, we have Pair Care, Heart for Home, Design Portfolio, another Design Portfolio, and Home Furnisher, and finally Juncture. And we will go through all of that in the next few minutes or hours, depends, but everyone has a queue, so we're well prepared, or I hope. So, I've been emceeing the whole day today, so So allow me to introduce Harbour.Space for people who are new. I see some new faces and old faces. So Harbour.Space University is a state-of-art university founded by Svetlana right there in Barcelona. And this is the second campus, and hopefully the second of many more, in Bangkok. So we have a partnership with the University of Thai Chamber of Commerce, and through that two melting powers of education, we created this campus that allows us to have so many individuals come here, work really hard on upskilling and reskilling, changing their majors, changing their careers, and taking it to a whole next level. From our graduates, we have people who freshly graduates from traditional universities joining us. We have people from corporates who left their jobs for a whole year to come here, reskill, and hopefully get a promotion. And we have people who came from a very, very different backgrounds, completely different backgrounds, such as tourism, and today they are changing their careers to entrepreneurship, design, or marketing. So I am here today, very proud of each and every one of you. I've been here since the beginning, and I'm so happy to witness the end / the new beginning of your end. So today, I really want you all to give yourselves a round of applause for making it this far and for being here. This place, these people couldn't come this far without a vision. And this vision was first started from the maker, the brain maker. Svetlana, I want you to join me on the stage, and I want you to give a welcome to our guests and graduates.
Thank you, Chaima. Thank you, dear guests, dear graduates. So nice to see your faces now in Bangkok after having seen you in Barcelona as well. You know, here we go freely between Bangkok and Barcelona, and we make friends here and there, you know? And finally the day had come. I mean, it's very sad always, you know, when this day comes, because we made friendships, right? We made the connection with you. And we've spent a wonderful year together, right? And, you know, Harbour.Space is a new university. Therefore, most of the graduates are master students. It's not yet the bachelor students that are graduating. So you guys have been amazing. I want to separately thank each and every one of you for making a very lasting contribution to this institution. I hope you become great ambassadors of what you've learned here, and that we can you know, continue being in touch. And of course, I totally agree with Chaima. I think you're all up for a promotion and for a great life and much more enhanced life, and enhanced by the experience here, by the people you've met here, by all the wonderful work that you've put together that you're going to showcase today. And of course, the travel experience, right? I wish all of you to continue exploring the world, to continue feeling one with the world, right? And also sharing with other people what, you know, what special things you've learned here. I think it is very important that the vision behind Harbour.Space and behind this joint venture with the University of Thai Chamber of Commerce had always been to bring here something innovative, something disruptive, because we wanted to share this with all of you, of course, the students, but also with the companies here in Thailand. We wanted the companies to be able to have home, academic home, you know, here, where they can seamlessly work with an institution that changes, that we call it an evergreen institution, because as you know, things here are modular. That means that, you know, teachers come and go. We don't have permanent teachers, and therefore every teacher that shines is here to stay. Every teacher that doesn't shine will not stay here, right? And the same goes for Bangkok as well as for Barcelona. You know, you've seen this year we've put together amazing roster of teachers that were teaching in both campuses. So it's the same, you know, group of faculty that teaches in Barcelona, it comes to Bangkok, and that is what makes it really, really special and amazing that you come to Barcelona. I know almost all of you know, I've been to Barcelona, and you've seen how seamless is the experience here and there. So you'd almost, you know, don't feel in terms of academics any difference. You study here and then you come there, and then, you know, you see the same kind of vibe, the same kind of quality, the same kind of rhythm. And what we do here differently, and this is something that I want all of you to know, is, you know, we learn in sprints. We do not learn in semesters, in six, you know, sort of months-long semesters. Because, you know, the life had been accelerating at an enormous pace, and therefore, our graduates, all of these graduates, if you ask them to do something like a presentation or a strategy, right, or a product, they can prototype it really fast. They can do it in a day because all of this year they've been working, no, on so many projects, and the expectations were very high from each and every one of those projects, and the speed at which they worked was, you know, enormously fast. I mean, you basically have to do a project every day because you only have 15 days to master a certain piece of knowledge. We call it a sprint. And conveniently, this is how the tech companies operate. They operate on sprints that are 3-week long sprints usually. And so these guys are absolutely ready to bring the speed to your organization. If your organization is ready to move to work in an agile manner, in a sprint manner, like all of the tech companies do, right? Or you could join any tech company and you'd be at home, you'd be feeling at home. You know, I always give this example about myself when I was young, you know, and I joined a bank after this kind of system from Finland, because this system comes from Finland. And my first assignment was to make a credit application for a terminal of an airport, right? I had to approve a credit. And the boss asked me, when is it going to be ready? I said, tonight. And the boss was shocked because they expected me to say maybe, I don't know, in 2 weeks or I don't know when. But I was, you know, I don't know. For me, that was very natural. So these guys are very speedy, you know, and the quality expectations that you can put on these guys are really, really, really high because they're used to being treated as, you know, complete adults, because one of the things that we have to make sure is that you guys graduate, you know, market ready, you know, job market ready, right? You head on. In addition to that, I want to separately mention that we teach here not just technical skills, right? We believe the technical skills are very important, but also the smart skills or soft skills. They used to be called soft skills, and I think now everybody calls them the smart skills. These are the skills such as leadership. It's taking an initiative. All of these guys, by now, know that it's fully their responsibility to take an initiative. If there's something missing, then, you know, they can also come forward and say it and do something about it. And they don't just bring the problems, right? They bring the solution first. They think about the solution. They don't come to their boss with the problem, but they come, you know, already thinking about what can be done about this problem. And they're ready to do it themselves. So people who are very resourceful people, people that will, I hope, lead these companies and any other places that you will join. And, of course, the community, right? Sharing all that with people around you, with your families, with your, you know, people at work as well. If you see, you know, also the culture we foster is that if someone is weaker and it's in your team, you don't put that person down, right? We put that person up, we lift all the boats, we try to help, we try to understand what is the cause and how to help these people. So, you know, we're here like a family. I mean, it's a small initiative, small institution. This year we will have about 100 students at a time. So it's still in the stage of prototyping. You know, we've been a little bit hit by the pandemic. I mean, not a little bit, I mean quite a lot. And, you know, the launch of the campus was delayed. However, you know, despite the slow start, I mean, we've had amazing students. You guys have been so amazing. I just want personally to say how important it was for me to be with you and your decision to join us. And I know that all of you are feeling very privileged, right, having gone through this experience. And I'm very excited to keep in touch, to know what's happening with you, what kind of contributions you make for your company, for the world, and, you know, society at large. And, you know, as I said, you're just amazing, all of you, in every imaginable way. So good luck in your endeavors there, absolutely there, to change the world. Become that change that you want to see in the world. So that's what I want to say. And for the guests, I'd like to say thank you for getting to know our students, our graduates today. For the teachers, I see Amarit came, our high-tech entrepreneurship teacher, who spent a lot of time here, brought a lot of people here. All of you who had helped, people from Bigreem, thank you so much. I mean, this collaboration with Bigreem had been instrumental to making this campus happen, this experience happen. Kirati, the chairman of the Mayflower, the educational consortium that made it all possible. And all of the new students, of course, you guys have to talk to the students that are graduating. Woo! And I hope that you guys get to know each other, the next generation, and tell them how to make the best of this experience. So today we're celebrating many things, but most importantly, we want to demonstrate so that instead of me talking and describing how marvelous and special this university is, I think the best is to listen to the projects, to listen to the outcomes, and then hopefully I can talk to all of you and you tell me what you think. But I've heard some comments before in the rehearsals, so they were very good comments. So let's hope that you guys keep it up, and thank you for all of you for coming. I don't know, Sawani is here. Sawani made it. I'm finishing, and maybe you, I don't know, you come, no? Thank you so much. It wouldn't be possible without Sawani, of course. I mean, actually, you know what Chaima said about the vision? I want to spend another, you know, 30 seconds on this. It does take a person with a vision to see a world in a different sort of state, right? Something that doesn't exist but should exist. But it also takes another person, right, who actually understands that vision and you know, and wants to do it together. And Sawani was the person at the time. She was the president of the University of Thai Chamber of Commerce. And she came to Barcelona during this day, actually the same day, demo day, and she saw the presentations and she really liked it. And I'm forever grateful for having Sawani with us. And the person who really made it is Sawani. So here to you.
We did it
together. Yeah, but here's to you.
I have a business to do with the Chamber of Commerce today. I planned to come back on the first flight from Mysore back to here, but then the flight canceled. So I had to travel by car from Mysore to Pisnolok. It took about 3.5 hours and then catch another plane and just arrive because this is such an important day. No one can miss it. Okay, looking forward to hearing all the demo today. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Sawani, the president of Harbour.Space at UTCC, Kapunaka. So today we have plenty planned for you. We've heard your voices throughout the year. I know you've been through ups and downs, good things, bad things, challenging things, But most importantly, you made connections, and not only with each other, but also with teachers who are now your mentors. So we reached out to your favorite teachers for graduation to record a message to all the graduates. So first person to have is the famous Eric. He is our CFO. He's the teacher teaching you financial modeling. I know this is a very hard module for people with no financial background such as me, but I know that by the end of that module, a lot of you improved, a lot of you thanked Eric, and today here is Eric to thank you. What happened to Eric? Okay, let's go.
Dear Harbour.Space at UTCC, graduating class of 2023, it was such a great pleasure to get to know you and have the chance to work with some of you this year. Congratulations on successfully completing your Harbour.Space learning experience and finally graduating with such an amazing group of people. You now have the skills to contribute positively in shaping the future of Thailand and beyond. I am so proud of you. I will just leave you with a few hopefully wise words. Try to use the golden rules we learned from financial modeling to help you plan and solve problems that you face in your life and career. One, be real and honest. Remember those realistic assumptions. Two, live with integrity, from our integrity of content. Three, don't complicate things. Clarify and simplify. And finally, don't forget to be yourself and make it your own. Wishing you all the best and hope we can stay in touch. Thank you.
Thank you, Eric. That was such a heartfelt message from Eric, and I know that you guys spent such a wholesome time with him. You went out, you had dinner, you had wine. I know he's a wine expert, so I know you spent so much time together, and I hope your connection will continue forever or when you need it. So without further ado, we will start our demo day today. And please allow me to introduce Ern, who is our graduate from a master's degree in digital marketing this year. And she is someone I know exactly for almost 2 years because she was just on an exchange when I joined Harbour.Space. She stayed with us for a few months and she left. By the time she graduated, I found her again here, and I was very surprised. What are you doing here? You just graduated. Go to find something. But she was so captured by this program that she decided to join for one more year here. And it was so good to see familiar faces once my friends left me. So it's so good to have Ern here. I presented her a project during Demo Day, which is exactly a year ago, with Cameron's class, and she started the same project that she's presenting today. And I cannot wait for you all to see her progress. Everyone, welcome Ern.
Thank you so much. Say more. Okay. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Ern. I am a master's student majoring in digital marketing at Harbour.Space University. Being at Harbour.Space here, it gave me a huge opportunity to meet many talented individuals like these people here. Please give them a round of applause. Thank you so much. Including, I got a chance to meet one of my friends. His name is Rico. He flew all the way from Indonesia to pursue his 1 year's master's degree at Harbour.Space. And you know what? after I talked with Rico and many of other international friends, I found out that settling in the new country is something not easy at all. Because you need to run around, finding some item, finding some furniture to settling at your new place. And it's really hard if you're not speaking Thai. Where, yeah, this country, we speak Thai a lot. And apart from that, it's somehow costly because you might want to purchase something, but you use it very short period of time, like 1 year. And then you need to later on try to figure a way to get rid of it. Maybe you want to sell it. Maybe you try to give away to people or donating it. That is a huge work, isn't it? That's why to help my friend and many other international friends coping with this issue, that's why me and my team, we come up with, we share. What you need, we have. What you have, we share. We are the first ever peer-to-peer rental platform that allow you to rent, save more money by renting instead of buying. Make more money by renting out your own item on our platform and create a more sustainable community in our societies. Why we share? We are aiming to be the first ever platform that provide you the best experience in rental service through affordable, hassle-free rental service. And in order to ensure that we sustain our community and the most importantly, leave our world a better place. Why we share? We provide you with the best rental rate. Why? Because anyone can rent anything on our platform. And by doing this, you don't need any actual shop, so you don't have extra costs. And you can also customize your own rental period, which is really accessible through the internet. And yeah, all the transactions will be done online. So just only one mobile phone and good Wi-Fi, that's enough for you to access to our service. And next is we secure you through the transaction. We provide you the insurance claim so you can ensure that when you rent things out here on our platform, all the items will be secured by us. And most importantly, we also hold the money for you. So you can ensure that when you rent things with us, no one will get your money and run away with it. And lastly, we have a variety of items because you can put anything to be rent out here on the platform. This is our MVP, how it looked like. I will walk you through our process. It's really simple, like any other app you used before. First of all, you can just need to sign up, put all the information, emails, or mobile phone. Later on, you will file out a category of item. You can go browse around, seeing what is available for me. After you file the information, you can see how was it look like, how was the condition, where it located, how was the review from the people from the previous one. And you can just go through all the booking process by shoot the date, and we will calculate everything for you, how much it costs. And later on, you will already finish the booking process. Next, if you want to list thing on our platform, it's really easy. You can just upload all the picture, the description, how much it costs, how the condition, like any other e-commerce you used to. This is our functioning website that we already host currently. There are some items out there ready for you to explore and rent it out, so feel free to explore our items. Why we share? Because we provide you a variety of items through our platforms. Anyone can rent anything. That is a really good part. You don't need to jump around, hop one by one to find different items. At the same time, we also provide you much more accessible because everything done online transaction. We are aiming to target 226,000 short-term stay expat and international students who stay for a short term in Thailand. And how we acquire this group of people? Through influencer marketing, social media marketing, I would say we have a really strong team of marketers behind this. After that, we also would like to use the SEO to ensure that our blog are visible to people, and most importantly, this part, referral programs and loyalty programs. Just to ensure that our clients, our user will become our advocate, just like Nico. we will ensure that he will recommend our service to his friend that are coming to be our student at Harbour.Space in next year. And how we make money. We take only 15% commission from each of the transaction with the 3.5% of 266,000 short-term stay expat and international student. Each of them, we get the commission 300 baht per person per transaction. Within the first year, we generate 2.8 million Thai baht. Within 20 months, we will break even with the number of user 23,000. And our revenue throughout the 3 years will look exactly just like this. With the 15% growth of the paid client in each month, within the second half of the second year, we will generate 800,000 Thai baht as an operation profit after we break even. We are seeking for a fund of 7 million Thai baht for 15% shares, which we will heavily invest this in the first year in the digital, in the marketing side, and also in the development of our website and application. And later on, we will heavily invest in the operation and maintenance later on. And of course, this project wouldn't be success without the hard working of the people who share the same value, advocate themselves to ensure that we live in the better worlds. With the team of multinationality, our friend from Morocco, from Indonesia, and me from Thailand, we are all absolutely understand the pain point of our user because we are a team that come and study here, we experience this ourselves. We combine over 5 years of experience in digital marketing, interaction design, business management, so you can ensure that we absolutely understand this issue. And we are a team with a dream, you know, big, big dream to make our world a better place. So feel free to join us, browse our item, rent something out, contribute to the world. And last but not least, we know you care. That's why we share. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Erin. Thank you. Thank you for this presentation. I saw it so many times, but it still gets me till this time. So for the new students, you know who to contact. If you need anything, it's Erin. So thank you, Erin. We are moving to our next presentation with a passion and a mission to elevate human experiences and create solutions that make a profound impact with ease. Ladies and gentlemen, let me welcome Eun. She is our graduate. No, it's Eun. Yes, it's you. Let me welcome Eun. She is our master's degree graduate in interaction design. Do you need some time? Okay. Yes. If Piki can come and assist Eun, because they're classmates and they work together for the whole year, so they know each other's project very well. They give each other feedback all the time. So please, again, welcome Eun.
Afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for coming and thank you for having me. Today, we're going to talk about the lighter thing, not the startup. We're going to talk about design. So today, I am Eun as a product designer within working in the industry. I want to show you all the portfolio and how we developed the product from the ground, from nothing. I want to show you all the screen so that we can see. Portfolio, for the design portfolio, we want to make it light mood. And as a product designer, I fell in love with the user flow. The user flow is a deliverable that we use to communicate the flow and journey before we designing the product. And here, I am driven by the processes and measurement. Are you ready to see my work?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Thanks. But I heard someone said no, maybe. We try it out. But please stay a little bit longer, just 10 minutes. And how about my work? This is the case study section in the portfolio. As a designer, we want people to see the work that we have done. But within the homepage, if we scroll down, I have a testimonial to show what people talk about me. I don't want to talk about myself. And for the fall, we will have the start and the end. If we click the end, but our journey does not end here. You can connect and schedule me for a call if we need something about design. Let's see the work. If we click in the work section, we will see the case studies and my publication that I have talked about the design, about typography and the design culture. But in today, I want to highlight the case study that I have worked with in this university. From the scratch, and we have found the idea of the travel application product. This is the case study that we have come up from the ground. We have nothing, and we have the idea validation for the travel application. Within this case study, I have studied in the class interaction design with our professor Irene. She's very talented, and within this class, we have run through 5 weeks, and we have 4 members to validate this idea. The brief was Lonely Planet want to make the application lively and relevant again. As you may know, the Lonely Planet is a travel business that have the books, that have website, that have guide tour and everything. But for the behavior, people used to look at the guidebook and travel. But nowadays, we have the application so that the book is not relevant. That's why we have to validate the idea and find out why it's not relevant anymore. And for the brief, our target audience is we want to connect with the Gen Z travelers. And we have found the interesting stat that more than 8 in 10 Gen Z travelers are seeking unique experience. We don't want to travel just to hit all the hotspots. How can we do that? We have the steps to validate the idea, and we divide it into 4 steps. First one, we have to set up the project, and after that, we have to research. After we have researched everything, so that we have some rough idea, and we have to validate it, that is it relevant to our market. And after we have validated through every idea, now it's time to making it real by building the prototype. This is where we, our customers, have worked together and have validated and interviewed the persona. And this is behind the scene. We have listed out all the pain points, and we recognize the pattern that it has been said among the Gen Z travelers. So we found that they need spontaneous traveling, authentic experience, and private sharing. How can we make all the ideas and all the saying to become a product. We found a persona that could be someone who used our product. And after that, we have researched through the ecosystem what kind of travel applications or solution that people use now, and we found the opportunity to make a product in this section. So we introduced Wani, a mobile application for travelers who seek the unique experience. Wani, if you are Thai, you may have heard, but if you are not, Wani means today, so that we want all the travelers to live today, to live spontaneously. And we analyzed all the competitors, we found the structure, and we did the user flows so that we know each step and we can make whole experience simple for the users. And after idea, you may know that we did from the scratch to prototype. And we make the brand identity to our app so that why we have the finished look of the product. And within this, we can first find the location that is hidden gem from each country through our app. That is the pain point from our validation. And also, the traveler these days, they want to share their stories exclusively. And this is how the app. Since it's the university project, I want to thanks to my team who did went through all the processes together. And not only work, we have the about page so that we can discover more about the designer. And I am a digital product designer. You can see my skill set here. And within this work experience, selected clients and people I have worked with so that I list out the product that I could help and we could collaborate together. And I can't wait to hear from everyone. If you have some design or user experience problem, we love to share. And let's have a coffee chat and connect together. Thank you.
Thank you, Eun. Thank you for your presentation. If you need any designer advice, you can connect with Eun. I'm talking to new students, old students, and people, our esteemed guests today. She has been always helpful to everyone, and I always see her in the open space, giving feedback, receiving feedback, and please come to visit when you can. So after talking to, let me stand here. After hearing from Eun, I would like you all to hear some words from her teacher and the program director and the famous Irene from Irene and Anton. So let's hear all from your teacher, Irene, and what she has to say to you.
Hello everyone, students of mine, congratulations, you're finally here, it's graduation time. That means it's both exciting as well as a little bit scary because now you have to go into the real world and see if everything that you've learned this past year actually makes sense. Some of you will stay in Thailand, some of you will go abroad, some of you will go back home. But whatever your future holds for you and wherever you might end up, remember that the community that you've built here with each other is important, and that even 20 years from now, there will always be a special place for everyone you've met here, regardless of where any of you end up. So congrats, everyone, and looking forward to seeing what everyone will do in the future.
Thank you, Irene. I know that some of you were residents in campus because of her classes. She gives back-to-back classes in UX, UI, and a lot of you were dying, and I appreciate that you made it so far. It's been a pleasure to see your hard work come into reality and to see the quality of such portfolios and such designs. So congratulations to all of you. Let's now move to our next startup. This is by a very hardworking individual, and I believe everyone can admit that, and everyone can say there is no hardworking person as PPAIR this year, and you have witnessed her working so hard, staying overtime. Even yesterday, she was here till 9 p.m., so please welcome PPAIR.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Pear. Today, I'm going to present my passionate project called PearCare. Imagine the world where finding the perfect caregiver for your loved one within few clicks. Welcome to PearCare, where we are revolutionizing how medical needs are fulfilled. As you can see, nowadays in Thailand, we have the problem. We lack of a leading platform to matching between the caregiver and care seeker. And we just have only the local SME and the caregiver as a freelance. And caregiver always stay far away from the care seeker. And care seeker take a long time to find a suitable caregiver. But not only this problem, we have the most important problem. Finding the trustworthy caregiver become a huge concern when they are need the suddenly medical needs. On the other hand, for the caregiver side, many caregivers struggle to find a job that's suitable for their skill. So from this issue that I have, from my work experience, so that's why PearCare stepped in. PearCare is a place where patient and healthcare provider meet and fulfill their medical needs and support. As you can see, our patients are high purchasing senior. And for another side, our healthcare provider are nurse aide, and a caregiver with experience. Moreover, our PearCare is easy, accessible, and we provide a professional service with the trustworthy and safety with the superior care. And nowadays, we already have a right official account and user-friendly, as you can see in the upcoming video.
Let's see how PearCare works. First, let us visit to our PearCare Line official account. Please click at the Find Care Providers button on the rich menu. Then, give information about your case, such as your contact info, who do you want the service for, and the health conditions. After entering the information, in your case will be sent to PearCare immediately. You will receive a message to wait for 4 hours for PearCare to find your best caregiver match. Within 4 hours, PearCare was sent the list of caregivers who match with your needs. Now, it is selecting time. You may now choose the favorite caregivers from our trusted list. After the selection process, PearCare will lead you to the payment flow. After your payment is successful, you will receive the booking details, which you can check again in PearCare Line official account. That's how it works. Easy, accessible, and trustworthy. So, let us pair and care for your beloved people.
And for our customer segments, we have two customer sides. One is the care seeker. The care seeker pay per care and they will get the good caregiver who match with them. And another side is caregiver. Caregiver pay per care and they get the job that match with their skill. And this slide will show you how big opportunity in Thailand market nowadays for PearCare. For the care seeker side, we focus on 10% of high purchasing senior. It's around 360 people. On the other hand, for the caregiver side, we focus on nurse aide, caregiver with experience who do home service, around 90,000 people. For our competitor in Thailand market nowadays, I try to emphasize you guys that PearCare really outstanding, as you can see from this lesson. One is we provide a professional service. Second, we do accessibility because our customer can list at by many channel. Third, we do quick matching just only 4 hours, within 4 hours. And the last one is we charge for the reasonable price. And how we can get the revenue maximization, we will use three strategies. For the first one is we will increase market share and transactional volume revenue expands. Second, we will increase and expand of high margin initiative. And for the third is we will optimize personnel structure and improving productivity. For the marketing strategy that we will use to acquisition our customer in the first phase. For the care seeker side, we will use five strategies. For example, I can use my connection, or maybe I can do the medical influencer or social advertise. And for the caregiver side, we will use four strategies. For example, I will cooperate with the nurse aid school, or I do the promotion or the social advertise. And how we can get the money? It's very easy. Everyone can imagine we will get the money from two sides of the customer. From the care seeker side, care seeker will give us for the matching fee, and for the caregiver side will pay us for the platform fee. And this slide will show you the primary revenue we will get from the matching fee. And PayCare have two KPI. For the first KPI, we will get total number of the caregiver on our platform, 20,000 people by the end of 2 years. And for the second, we will get 25 ratio of matched in every quarter. That means every caregiver get employees. And for our roadmap, we will start to do the product on the September 2023. We will develop our live application and we will testing. At the same time, we will develop the promotion for the customer and we will do the content for do the workshop for the company. Then we will launching for the PayCare application on the November 2023. And for the last phase, we will measurements and evaluation. And it is how financial projection PayCare will break even in 27 months with customer from caregiver 69 people and for the matches it 2,504. And this is our financial projection for 2 years. As you can see, we will have 15 million baht at the end of 2 years with around 3,500 matches that we will be able to employ the caregiver more than 9,000 people. And this is our PayCare hunting team. Our team led by me, who work in medical field more than 10 years. And moreover, a team with 4 professionals from different fields. With this skill and dedicated team, we are confident in our ability to solve this problem. And we also have my advisor here, Dr. Thotsapon Selilak, a member of the House of Representatives. And our objective by the end of 2 years, PayCare will get revenue 15 million baht and get 1 million baht for the EBITDA. And we will get the number of matches in each month around 350 matches. And we will get target valuation around 60 million baht. So PayCare asked just for only 4 million baht at 20 million post-money valuation. So this is how we use our fund when you invest in my project. If you are interested about my project or have some question, feel free to contact me and my team. Or you can scan this QR code to get more information. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Per. That was quite the presentation. And just like I said before, these are people who come from different industries, and people like Pipe here today who comes from a medical industry and who has a plan to have a bigger impact than just helping one person at a time. So thank you, Pipe, for your presentation. Thank you, Mr. Advisor, for attending the graduation today. So, speaking about caring, we will move to another project that is very, very caring. And this is a project that I find very heartwarming. And I would like you all to welcome to the stage Winnie and Louis, two master's degree graduates from Harbour.Space at UTC this year. You can clap now.
The greatness of a nation can be judged by its animal get treated. This is the quote by the Mahatma Gandhi. So a picture says 1,000 words here. I'm $1,000 and I'm free. So this is so sad. So let's see the real problems here. More than 180 kestrel animals are roaming around in Myanmar that are in need of the proper care and the shelter. So we have two main problems here. Luckily, people nowadays are open to an idea of adopting pets from animal shelters. So the first problem, they are more comfortable with adopting pets from accredited animal agencies. And the second problem is a lot of paperwork problem. The paperwork process can be intimidating and overwhelming for them. Ladies and gentlemen, this is where Heart for Home comes in. We are the user-friendly platform that aims to connect the furry friends to our loving home. And we aim to simplify the process, connecting the pets and pet owners, and we will create the loving home for them. So we aim to transform the life of a stray animal one at a time, creating the loving home. And in order to achieve this, we strive to empower the pet owners, and we will rescue the animals through collaborations and educations. So more than 8.2 million people are in Myanmar who are open to adopting pets. And also we would like to focus mainly in the key cities. We aim to achieve 5% of the total market, which is 215K. So this is our first persona, Sheila. She is a working professional and she always longs for a company. As you can see here, she is mostly active on different social media platforms. And our second persona is David. He is the family-oriented person and business owner. As he is a businessman, he is only active on business-related channels. So, Heart for Home is the market pioneer in Myanmar, so we don't have the direct competitor here. So we did research in other markets. We found partner and pet finder who have similar approach as Heart for Home. In terms of positioning, we can say Heart for Home is more professional-driven with fully assistance. I'll pass to Louis to talk about the product MVP.
So we'll show you right away the platform. Let me just load it up first. So this is our prototype. So what we aim for this platform is to really standardize and standardize the adoption process for Myanmar, given that there's a huge market for pet adoption, specifically those who are adopting pets from different agencies and different shelters in Myanmar. So from the homepage, you can start adopting already. So once you click adopt, you get to choose between a cat or a dog. And let's say for this example, we'll choose a dog. So you get to choose from the many animals that are available from our partner shelters. So from there, you get to learn more about the animals that are available for adoption. But we know that adopting is too big of a commitment to really pursue. So that's why if your heart's not into it yet, you also have the option to donate. And you have actually two options there, which is you can donate to any of our accredited partners, or you can donate to our team. So we're actually a nonprofit, so most of the funds that we get here are going into our team and to our platform, just so that we can innovate further. Speaking of revenue, since we are a nonprofit, we aim to really rely on these revenue streams, which are to partner up with different brands, as well as through donations. But of course, the donations part will mostly go into our platform, to giving our team a livable wage, as well as leveraging on sponsored content and strategic ad placements. And to talk more about the marketing side of things, I'll pass it on to Winnie.
Thank you. So how are we marketing Heart for Home? We will have four main objectives here. First, we would like to increase 30% of the total awareness across the country by quarter two of 2024. And the second objective, we will be nurturing and educating the people about adopting pets from the animal shelters. And moving down the third option, we will be increasing about the adoption rates. And lastly, we will foster a supportive community that look like people to Heart for Home. Yeah, this is how we are doing our marketing split. As Heart for Home is mostly web-based, digital marketing will primarily be used to target our target audience. So as you can see here, this is how the detail breakdown of how we are splitting our marketing budgets into. To sum up here, you can see 84% of our marketing effort will go into the digital marketing, and the remaining 60% will be communicated through offline marketing. Now, financial modeling will be presented by Louis.
In terms of finances, we did our best to really cut down on costs as much as we can, only because this is a very passionate project of ours. So we make sure that all of the revenue that we actually get will go into our team. And speaking of team, let me introduce to you our team. Next, So it's actually just the two of us. So by trade, we're digital marketers, of course, but by heart, we're very passionate about animal welfare and pets in general. So we wanted to pursue this project only because we feel that we have a lot to give in this aspect. So that's why we're here today to ask for $50,000 USD to really kickstart our project. So I mentioned earlier that as a nonprofit, we make sure that everything that we get will be returned to either our team, our platform, or to our partner shelters. So most of the funds that we do get will go into the payroll, as well as going into marketing our platform. So if your heart's in it, please do contact us. Again, we're Heart for Home, and thank you for listening today.
Thank you, Louis. Thank you, Winnie. When are you opening a branch in Thailand? Because I'm planning to adopt. So we are halfway there. We still have three more presentations to go. So I hope you're still here, still feeling well. How are we feeling? Good? Okay, good. So we can go to our very next... We have a message. We have a message from someone that is not only your favorite teacher, but she was my favorite teacher first. So yeah, it's my favorite teacher first. So let's hear from your favorite behavioral marketing marketer, Kenda.
Are you ready? Hello to my beautiful Bangkok students. You're definitely my favorite students because my Barcelona students are making me record this right now. I miss you guys so much, and I'm so proud of you guys now that you've come to your graduation point. You did a great job, from the naughty sausages at the front of the class, to the girls at the back, to the naughty kids right at the back of the class, you smokers, I see you, and then everybody in the front who was the individuals and the clever little sausages. I'm very proud of you guys for reaching this point. Now, as you go forward in life and you continue to build on the things and the lessons that you've learned, not just in my class, but across all the classes, if you focus on personalization and you focus on making sure that you are continually creating an environment in which you are educating and adding value, you're always going to have an amazing impact on the rest of the world. And I'm so, so proud of all of you. please go forth and be absolutely amazing little sausages, and I love you lots.
Thank you so much, Kendra. I know that you are having fun with this message. And for you guys, if you get a promotion, give her a call. She wrote an email to your HR, by the way. Yes. So she was very, very proud of some students here coming from a corporate background that she wrote their HR email. So if you get the promotion, call her and invite her for coffee. Okay, now we move to another portfolio. What do you get when you mix fashion and interaction design? You get Alisa, everyone.
Good afternoon, everyone. As you can see from my portfolio, I'm Alisa Apon Suksili. I'm a designer with a range of experience in UX UI, fashion, and graphic design. But before I jump into the detail, I would like to tell you a little bit about my story. I'm a designer who passionate about creating products that helping people feeling better with their life through stunning product experience. I believe that true transformation starts from within. Imagine you wearing clothes that make you feel confident, bring out the best of you. Similarly, I aim to create products that make your life easier and more enjoyable. You can also see my story here, my experience here, and my education. And talk about education, I'm proud to say that I'm graduate in Master of Interaction Design from Harbour.Space. And this place has been my gateway to new worlds, new friends, and experience and opportunity to grow. And today, I would like to showcase some of my projects that I have been working since I study here. Can you scroll to UX UI? Yes. Yes. So we have been doing some projects like Neon, Travel Bud, and at ease. And I would like to show the one that I really like. I working with a group of friends in Harbour.Space, Neon, a website to discover nightlife and connect with people. So first of all, it starts from a group of friends. We work and study together. Sometimes we burn out and stay with life. And we usually ask ourselves, like, where should we go tonight? And it was not easy to find the right place for us. And we would like to, why don't we seek for the solution to finding exciting way to find the right place. So here's the overview, the website to discover nightlife. So when we want to do, we start to making a plan and we did some research, which we found nightlife markets. It's 100 industry with 30 billion market cap, and this is in Bangkok alone. So we dig deeper, talking to the user. We found that 60% of Gen Y in Bangkok, they like to go to nightclub and bar at least once a month. And the average spending is 1,300 a night. So we want to target them, and we come to talk to user. And here's what we found. First is difficulty. Some of them are, it's not easy to booking for the famous places, or it's not easy to find information about the event, promotion, and deals. It's about diversity as well. People are different. They like different kind of music, places, and also people. Third is the privilege. Some of them want to feel special when they go out or go to the nightclub and bar. Fourth is the cost. Cost is one of the factors that influence people's choice and decision. And the last one is connects with other. Some of interviewees, they want to connect with like-minded people. So we do the metric to define the scope, and we make a persona. And we also went to the bar nightclub to talk to the owner. So we also found like not every bar and nightclub are quite famous. Some of them are quite stuck like during COVID. So we would like to help them as well. So we prioritize need doing domestic. And then after we have been doing some research, we would like to solve all this problem. We come to the app concept. We would like to help user and owner of the bar and club. So for the user, we would like to help them finding the perfect nightlife spot. We would like to help them to book night out with ease and also help them to connect with others. And for owner of the bar and nightclub, we would like to help them to get more customer, target the right customer for them, and also can promote like the events and promotion and deal. So we also do business model, competitive analysis. And from what we have been doing research, we went to the bar and nightclub, we see the beauty of the night, which come to the art direction. So we start to do UX UI, making logo, neon, and start with, we use the color from the light of the street at night, which come to UX UI. We made the site map, and here's our homepage. And we also do wireframe, and this is the order page. This is the overview. So after we come out with the website, we validate the idea. We seeking to see like if it met with customer need with a value proposition, and then we identify refinement to improvement plan. And yes, I would like to reflecting of our journey as well, like. We been to meet the owner of the bar and the club, the DJ and artist, which it was quite challenging for us because they available quite late, like 1 or 2 a.m. But the time was quite enjoyable, and we heard from like the beautiful story, the beautiful of the night, which come to neon concept. And which is why we call our team the Night Owl. It's all a student from Harbour.Space. And yes, if you would like to get to know more about Neon, want to book the ticket, you can scan here. And if you would like to know more about me, you can scan for my portfolio. And lastly, I also would like to say a big thanks to my mentor, my friend, everyone in Harbour.Space, everyone who have been a part of my amazing journey. Without all of these, none of this would have been possible, so thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Alisa. Thank you. Alisa has been to both campuses, so she got the double experience for being here and for being in Barcelona as well. It is quite important to highlight that people here are meant to be built as a full-rounded person. As you can see, Alisa is not just a designer, but she is someone with the mindset of an entrepreneur, someone who has the vision of creating projects as well. So this is something that we try to have here at Harbour.Space, where you are not only what you're designed to be. So to stay in style, let's move to our next, the one before the end. Just to let you know, our next presentation with Atisha, who is our high-tech entrepreneurship master's degree student. Please welcome Atisha.
Thank you, Shema. Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you for coming here today. Please let me introduce my platform that will help people to create their interior design easier. This is Home Furniture, an AI interior design generator. I'm sorry. But it doesn't work. No, it's... Oh, I'm sorry. Okay. Sorry for the technical problems. Okay, we can start now. This is Home Furniture and AI Interior Design Generator. My name is Atisha. I am a master's student in high-tech entrepreneurship at Harbour.Space with 12-year experience in home living design. And I hold a master's degree of science in real estate development and with interior design background. So from my background, you can see my passion about home living. And I really believe that great design can bring well happiness and well-being to people. So this brings to my vision is the home furniture vision to offer an easy way of happiness and well-being to customers through the design and best experience. How to reach this mission? How to help people? So we have to know more about our customers. Let's meet Nam Tan. She is my friend living in Bangkok. And congratulations to her, she just got married. And she bought a new house to stay with her husband. She doesn't have any designer. She always wants to ask me a lot of questions, like how to buy the good furniture, or maybe is like, does this chair match to that table? Please trust me, I really, really want to help her. But talking with Nam Tan make me realize that not only Nam Tan, not only my friend, but a lot of people have the same challenges. It's a big opportunity to help people, and it's a big market. From the home decor data in Thailand, the SOM is about 540 million baht, and home furniture want to reach 10% of the SOM. It means more than 20 households and 20 house owners. What is their process? What they do to get a good design? Maybe you are the one that going in the process as well. So this is really long time to making a decision to decorate your house. Maybe it takes 6 months. At first, you are so excited. You just like, oh wow, this is my home, and you try to find a lot of idea from Pinterest or magazine, and you going to see the furniture store and you try to calculate the budget, and when you try to match everything, you feel like, oh, how can I do it? You feel frustrated or maybe disappointed and you want to give up. In your head, you feel like, oh, I want to move to my new home as soon as possible and I want to skip all this long process. These are three main pain points. The one is about imagination. You cannot imagine the total look of your actual room and you feel unconfident with your design skill. The second one is about finding the furniture because you don't know where to buy the furniture even you know the style you like. And the last one is about the budget because you cannot calculate the budget when you select the item piece by piece because you cannot see the overall. So this is the solution. This is home furniture. Why home furniture? What we can help? The first one is time saving. From 6 months with many frustration, you will use only 1 month to design your home without frustration and feel good along the journey in our platform. You can save 5 months. It means you can move to your home faster and no need to pay any loan debt without living in your new beautiful house. The second one is about the variety. In our platform, we have more than 5 room types that let you create and design and generate your photo that cover all area in your house. The last one is about our library. In our library, we have more than 10 brands that have many, many branches all over the area of Thailand that make you easy to reach out, and it's like it means you can have many wide range of the prices and the design. So this is the way that home furniture can help you. There's only 3 easy steps. The first one is you just upload your photo and select, and that's it. You will get your design. You can use the platform on your laptop, on your iPad, and on your mobile phone. Let's go through the detail. At first, you just take a photo like this. It's very easy. And you upload in the platform. And after that, you can see the drop-down that you can select the room type and room style. And we have many, many types that you can select. After this, you will get the design. This is just for you, only you. And you can go more to see the detail like this. You can see your photo that generated from our platform. And you can click each item and see where to buy and where and the price. We have 2 ways to generate our revenues. The first one is access fee, and the second is extension fee. People pay this, and after that, they will get the design, price, and place to buy. It's very easy. And in the future, we can go to be partner with our furniture brands. You pay only 990 baht for the access fee. You can use it for 2 months. That's very enough for your design. And you can pay the extension fee if you want to use it continuously. We can do social media to create virality, and we can go cooperate with the influencer to make them decide, and we will send the email marketing to them to update our progress. So in the future, we can cooperate to be a partner with furniture stores that they can do the advertisement on our platform, and we can get a commission from them if they post their item on our platform. So there are a lot of competitors in the market. The first one is the premium one that give you a full range of designs and service. And the second one is they are the platform that you have to do the 3D scale yourself. And the last one is the AI generator. They can provide you just only design, but you cannot find a place to buy, or maybe you need some design skill to do your design by yourself. So Home Furniture will solve this. We can solve all the problems. You can do the design easily with the budget, and we cover all the advantages of the competitors in only one platform. So we can launch our product after getting the fund, and we can go partner after that. We will break even in 14 months with 3,000 users. And you can see the revenue go continuously. And we will get 22 million baht in the 3rd year with 3 million baht net profit. So we are asking for 3 million baht for 15% of the company at 20 million baht post money valuation. So this fund we'll use for marketing, for library operation, and for the development of our platform to make sure that our customers will get the best experience along our platform. This is very clear roadmap for our next 6 months that make we sure that we can answer all of customer need by testing it before launching to make people sure that they will get the best experience. So this is Home Furniture. If you are seeking the happiness through design, if you think about the world that happiness and well-being equals great design, think Home Furniture. Thank you.
pleasure.
Thank you so much, Atisha. This has been a great presentation. With all this creativity and innovation, I can think of only one person who took this campus by storm. He is the interaction design favorite teacher. Joshua, everyone, has some words for you.
Hey, welcome to my studio. Man, it has been a crazy couple of weeks. I got to hang out with you all for 3 weeks there in Bangkok, Thailand. And what an amazing experience that was. You know, 28 years ago when I first got it started, I was a painter, you know. I thought, okay, this is what I'm going to do. And something happened, you know, something shifted. And it just came naturally because no one was kind of doing what we were doing at that particular time. And I had this moment where this path laid out in front of me. And I knew that I was still going to be a painter, but I was going to be using programming and computers. And, you know, I've spent 28 years teaching workshops and teaching students like yourself all over the world with the help, with the hope, really, the help and the hope that I'd hook a few of you, you know, get you hooked on this idea that a different path could lay before you, one that involves using code and programming. First day, fun. Second day, man, I had some real concerns. I had some worries that maybe, you know, I was going to make this too difficult. And you guys proved me wrong. Over the course of that 3 weeks, you guys really showed me that you guys were up for the challenge. And some of you killed it. It was amazing, the things that you produced. So remember that the path is of your choosing, you know? The type of work you make is the type of work you'll get hired to do. And I hope that all of you graduating, congratulations. I hope that the path before you is revealed. And I'm so excited for you guys to walk that path. And can I get a hallelujah? Miss you guys. Congratulations. Keep in touch.
This has been great. I missed the opportunity to meet Joshua this year, but not next year. I hope you enjoyed his class. And for the new students, I will hope for you to meet him and meet his energy that really is captivating. So I know you are tired. We have one more, just one more, so please be a little bit more patient. Today, we have a lot of graduates as well as our respected people from different companies. So someone had to take one for the team and play matchmaker. And this someone couldn't be just C2. That never shies away from challenges, and C2 is going to present his company today, Junctor. Please welcome C2.
So I've been working in HR industry for 4 years, and as you can see, CV, 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 you have to like dip in your head in the piles of work. And that's exactly how we HR and recruiters feeling. But rest assured, the problem doesn't end there. As we can see, there are altogether 67% of the employers in the Southeast Asia's regions currently facing with the inefficient and time-consuming recruitment processes. Not just only that, and trying to find for the right talent and right skill itself, it's finding a needle at a haystack It's quite troublesome, isn't it? And the last thing, of course, the study by the LinkedIn found that 22% only of the companies in the region itself it's trying to use for the data inside for the companies to make a decision, then where is the quality decisions making point? Therefore, we trying to talk about these problems with hundreds plus of an HR professional from Myanmar, from different industry, and they all come together and demand for the revolutionized solutions. That is a fact which we can't deny, as after the COVID-19, the way we communicate, the way we walk, has drastically changed. And I can assure you, the way we communicate and the way we recruit to the talents is changing as well. That's why we, Genta, would like to be here. Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Situ. I'm from Burma. Obviously, I'm wearing the Burmese traditional like longji here. And I am the chief sales officer, and I will tell you why you need that type of groundbreaking solution today. So, our research indicated there are altogether 8 to 12 weeks to find for the right talent. It's quite long just to find for one person. So we would like to produce a solution itself by giving for all-in-one CRM recruitment, collaborative platforms, and personalized job portal. But let's try to see just about what the deeper meanings of it. So our product have two parts. The first one is job portal, where you can try to post your job vacancy and apply for jobs. And the second part is the applicant tracking system, where you can sort and organize for those talents. And starting with the dashboard, of course, you will be able to see the reports, customizable timelines, and real-time status, and of course, with some of the data insights, for example, like time to hire, cost to hire. And the second part is about the filtering, which is powered by the AI technology. So we have basically two parts again. RF stands for resume fit. The second one, application form fit, AFF. The RF. So when the candidates submit a CV, the system will automatically is trying to catch the keyword and trying to match with the job description that you have provided and trying to give you the fittest resume as a score system. So sit back and relax and just to try to see about the candidates applies and afterwards like, oh yeah, choose, oh yeah, which one is the best? And another thing is about the keyword searching. So imagine in 1,000 CVs in your database and you want a talent, which is only with the backgrounds of an HR and a sales. Don't worry about it. Just try to type the word HR and a sales and the system will automatically bring it to you on your table. So this is the other part of a communication. Of course, it's quite time consuming again to communicate with each and every talent. So why don't we automate it? Those all type of steps. Email automations, and also for the real-time status about how to communicate with them, right? And this is our job portal. So after we used those type of solution, we can try to move faster for twice. That's right, twice faster. So the after we have like done with those type of product, of course, we are trying to aim to secure for a significant amount of like a market share in Southeast Asia, especially for the developing country, Myanmar, Cambodia, Vietnam, Laos, where there's some talent, there's always be a market, there'll always be a business. And of course, this is our competitor analysis. We have applications tracking systems and everything there, but don't worry about the CV database at this point because we are the startup, but I can assure you again, we will catch up the rest of the others in no time. And this is our first business model. It's for the business owners and the companies. We have three different options, starting with $9 per month to $99. And of course, this is the 50% discount to the first user. Well, you will be receiving after the 2 months free trial. And of course, we a second business model for the job applicants. Of course, they will be submitting their CV and applying for job free, of course, again. But if they would like to have for the enhanced benefits, just like job hunting with AI or trying to get for the monthly time career consultation with our in-house HR, those type of benefits you will be receiving just only $4 per month. So this is our attraction. Of course, we GenCheck started last year, and right now we have launched the beta version in the June 23, and we are currently trying to give them for the 2 months free trials and start collecting for the feedback and measure and evaluating. And how do we do for the market, the go-to-market strategies, right? As you can see, we are currently running as the POC project, and we're still going to be trying to do for the overseas expansion and especially in Southeast Asia's market first. And this is our capital injection. We will be trying to break even at the 17th month with those type of 180 basic user, 220, 25. And of course, by that time, we will be receiving around 30,000 CV database. And this is our financial projection more, and this is our current flow, where we will be receiving 500,000 net profit at the end of the year three. As I've just told you before, we have exit strategies as well. Since the SEEK itself is online employment, which is quite huge enough in the Asian Pacific region, but for after GenCheck, we will try to cover it for developing country if they would like to be in a collaborating with us. Then afterwards, we can just try to give them for those type of 90,000 CV database. And also, so after the year three valuation, we have $5 million USDs right there. And we can still try to get a few for 40 to 50% IRR there. And this is our founding team member. We all are from Myanmar. We have a diverse network, diverse background. And of course, we have a shared vision and ambitions as well. And now, that's the best part, is that we are asking for only for 150K USD with the pre-seed funding round as that 1 million USD for the post-money valuation itself. And of course, we will be trying to use the funds very wisely, as you can see from there. And if you are interested, of course, our platform already up. So this is for the job story, job portal, and this is for the juncture for the ATS itself. So ladies and gentlemen, please, again, the future is in front of you, right? Why don't you grab it? Why did you use it? Why did you just try to keep moving forward with those type of a really manual thing? Why you can do this? Don't worry about it. Save the earth, by the way. Anyway, thank you very much, and I'm looking forward to have potential collaborations with you guys.
Clean up your mess, Situ. Thank you, Situ. Of course, dramatic as always. And we love it. We love it. This is Situ throughout the whole year, and we cannot get enough of him. So thank you for your presentations today. We reach the end of demo day, but not the end of our graduation ceremony. We will have a break in a few minutes, so please feel free to go grab something to drink, chit-chat, and have the opportunity to talk to our graduates. These has been 7 projects out of 42 graduates we have here. So please make sure to talk to other people who you didn't see here, because I'm sure they have something to say about their own projects, their own experience, their own designs and case studies. So everyone, please be back here by 3:30 and enjoy your break. Thank you so much. Kapuna ka. Thank you. day for all of us, and especially for the graduates and for the staff, because we're tired. But really, it's been an honor to work beside you all and to facilitate your time here and to help you in whatever you need. So it's been such a pleasure for us on behalf of all the staff members today. I would want to thank you all for being such a nice people. I want to thank you all for the emails you sent us afterwards thanking us. Thank you for your time here, your small gifts, tea, and everything that you did for us as a way to show your gratitude, and we are forever thankful for that. Thank you so much.
Okay.
So let's kickstart our graduation ceremony, our final event for today on campus, but not the last event, because we will have an after party and all of you are invited, of course. So please come to the after party and bring your best dance moves. So let's party and let's celebrate your 1 year long of efforts and hard work, because you're done. Yes. So as a start, I was looking for something inspirational to say, and I couldn't find something better than one of my favorite authors, who is Maya Angelou. And she says, "We delight in the beauty of the butterfly, but rarely admit the changes it has gone through to achieve that beauty." And today, each one of you had undergone a lot of change to become who you are today. I know that a lot of you will go with more of an open-mindedness, more tolerance, because you had some teammates to kill and you didn't kill them, and you managed to be here today untouched, and I'm so happy. I know you are laughing. We witnessed some challenges, but I know you overcame them. And because today we have one of our faculty members, we have Mr. Kun Amarit here today, and I wanted him to join me on stage to give you some words of wisdom and advice and to express his anything that you think is valuable for your students. Thank you.
Folks, it's an honor. I didn't know this was on the menu until like 5 minutes ago, but I always have something great to share. So I think coming to the end of the graduation, a lot of people talk about the end and new beginnings. But I have to say that I think throughout the next, 40, and all of us will probably live to 120 or maybe forever with new technologies, life can be both very long but also very short. At 20, I had the chance to almost perish, kill myself and three friends while driving when I was in my second year of uni. And I only survived because I hit a car before I hit a tree. And the moment I hit that tree, all I could say was O-S-H-T-I. And I'm like, that was the end of Amrit's life, just driving around and gone. I walked out of the car, and all my friends with no seatbelts were alive. And I was like, That is insane. That is impossible. We were traveling at 90, and we could have all gone. But I realized from that moment on was I was given a second chance to live. And I asked myself, so what am I going to do with that life? And that, from that moment on, I changed the trajectory of how I lived and how I spent the rest of my days, because I am living on a borrowed time. And I believe that if all of us know that we are mere mortals, we are a speck of dust in this universe, we're only spending a short amount of time, and you are given all the tools and the creativity and the opportunities to be whoever you want to be through Harbour.Space, to do whatever you want, to make an impact in humanity, in your community, in your life, how would you, the time that you have, which we do not know how much we have, and I would want to let you know that if you continue to figure out, and you always have to figure this out for the rest of your life, because one of my best lines that I always say to people is, I don't know what I want to grow up to be. I never knew I was going to be becoming teacher at Harbour.Space, or being an angel investor, or building conferences for 20,000 people, or running co-working spaces, or trying to be a barista. But through so many of those failures, trying so many different careers, I know a lot of people say, like, Amy, you have the longest LinkedIn in the world. What are you doing? How old are you? People are surprised. And I just have to say that through all those failures that you see on my LinkedIn has led me to come here and share my experience in the lectures, high-tech entrepreneurship. And for folks that will take it next time, it's going to be bigger, better, bigger, and more insane. So gear up. Last but not least, now that I did not, yes, kill my friends, I like other folks that want to kill your classmates here. I have to say, it ended up that one of the guys in that car became a founder that I now support. One of the guys ended up becoming an angel investor. And even though I almost actually got them to meet their untimely end, they realized that what has happened also shook them to the core. Also felt that, what are we actually, as a group in this class, what are we destined to do together? Because we are here not by random chance and luck. You are united. You are brought here for a purpose. And until you keep talking, until you keep staying connected and finding out why, you not realize the magical moments you have. And that would be the thing that will carry on for the rest of your career, because if you remember all the classes that were taught, I'm sure a lot of you are like, you know, it's a little hazy now and I'm really ready to go into my career and do other crazy things, get on with life, have kids, build a startup, you know, retire. But through that journey, you will face adversity, you will run out of funding, you will have problems with your co-founders, you have problems in your marriage, in your life, you'll relocate countries, you know, the next pandemic and wars. But the people in this room and the people that you collect in your life are the folks that will carry you through wherever you want to go. And I have never been more blessed to have incredible folks that have saved my company, saved my life, save my marriage, save my sanity during the pandemic. And those people, they're not always the people that you expect. They could be the people here that you meet. But if you don't stay connected, if you don't keep the spirit of Harbour.Space Drive and community, this would have been all a waste. It would just be another name on a Slack or a WhatsApp group. So please continue to be a champion and embrace, be the brand ambassador and the spokesperson for the magical moments that have happened here. And I can't wait to, I think I might invest or join one project here from the Harbour.Space team. I hope to do more. Really excited that this opportunity has happened. And I can't wait to invest in one of you. And especially if I can't, it doesn't matter. But if you are a unicorn founder, please don't mind mailing me some shares. Very much appreciated. But congratulations once again to get to the end. And congratulations for the many new beginnings that are about to happen. Thank you.
Kapunaka kun Amarit.
Yes,
I hope some of the remaining students will join your class in module 2, right? From Hero to Dream Team. Thank you again for your speech. So we reached the most important moment of the day, the moment where you get awarded for your achievements. This year we have 8 students who are graduating with honors. I know we say we do not care about grades, but a lot of people here put so much dedication to get the highest grades and to deliver in the best way possible. These are the people you trust with your life because they go and check what they need to be doing and they do it perfectly. So this without forgetting that all of you today are graduating with so much more than just grades. So I'm just letting you know, everyone is important, everyone is equal, but some people just achieve for greatness. They are not satisfied with anything. So today, I will say your names, and please excuse me if I butcher them. I'm so sorry, it's on me, and I will apologize later on. So let me introduce you to the 8 graduates gradually. We will go from the lowest to the highest. And we can have some drum rolls. Drum rolls, everyone. So the first person graduating with a GPA higher than 3.7, almost 3.8, with an honor of cum laude, he is Washiravit Sharitnam Pinyu. Yes, Pinyu. Thank you. I would like to invite Svetlana to the stage to give everyone their diplomas. And I would like to invite Kun Kiratit, the one who is one and from many investors who believed in Harbour.Space from the very beginning. He has been not only an investor, but a partner. And he's also the boss of some of you here that are working at Ocean Life. So this goes without saying that these people here not only believe in our students, but they try to give them opportunities to succeed in the real world. So please join me alongside Svetlana here to give graduates their diplomas. Thank you. Yes. So, Pinyu, go ahead. Please. Can you move a little bit to the front so the projector is not in your face? Thank you. Pinyu is so tall, I cannot cut his head, you know? Thank you. The next person, actually with the very, very same GPA, which is very surprising, they come from the same company, their colleagues. This year we had the We were colonized by the SCG people. So this year, the next in line is Patarawan Shansamrit Pinawan with an honor of cum laude. Please go. Next in line, this is the next honor. It's called Magna Cum Laude. With a master's degree in digital marketing, please congratulate Te Miet Sintu Pei. Go from here. Pei got a GPA higher than 3.8. Next in line, one of our favorite people here, and I know a lot of you like him, with an honor of magna cum laude and a master's degree in interaction design, please congratulate Rico. Rico got a final GPA of 3.86. Next in line, we got another honor of magna cum laude. This person is... I don't have enough words for you, Ern. I run out of words to say about Ern, but with a master's degree in digital marketing and a lot of credits this year because she studied everything and anything here and in Barcelona campus. Please congratulate Ern. 80. She has 80 credits in her 1 year. With a final GPA of 3.89. Our next person is the final person for our magna cum laude honors. With a master's degree in digital marketing and the same GPA as Ern, please congratulate Tananat Pipan. Of course, I've seen you guys working every single day here, and I'm so proud of you. So, for the highest honors, summa cum laude, please congratulate Pipro with a master's degree in digital marketing and one of the highest GPAs for this year. Please congratulate Pipro. And the final moment with the highest GPA for batch 3. Can I get some drum roll? The highest. Oh, you stood up. How would you know? So, the highest GPA this year, summa cum laude honor, goes to a master's degree graduate in digital marketing, Mr. Poop. Yes. Congratulations to all of you. After this, I would like to invite Poon for his speech. He will give today a speech. So please give him a round of applause. And let's listen to Poon's speech. Thank you.
Thank you, Shimmer. I think it's not the speech. It's just a little talk, like just 1 or 2 minutes. Yeah, okay, it is my honor and my pleasure to receiving this reward, and it's unexpected. I want to give a thanks to SCG company which provide me this big opportunity at Harbour.Space. Thanks to our Harbour.Space staff, all the dedicated professors who for their commitment to provide us with all the best and preparing us into like the real world business. For me, like from here and at Harbour.Space, I learning a lot, many things, and I see a lot of new possibilities for the business world. And I want to thanks to like my family, my God, like who always with me in every situation. I cannot be here without them, and to all of my friends. Yeah, you have made this journey amazing, and like good vibrant from all of you. I have nothing to say, but thank you for your friendships and for your supportive. It is valuable to me. Last thing for me, academic excellence is not about the grades. It's about how we transform our knowledge into practical action. And as we going to step into the real world business, professional world. So I want you to remember this is not about achieving perfection, but it's about delivering like beyond other expectation and making real difference to the world. Once again, I want to congratulate to us all for achieving this significant milestone. Thank you.
Thank you for your 1 minute not speech. Okay, can I have Svetlana and Kunkirat again back so we can have the rest of the graduates today and we can celebrate them as well. You are all special in my heart. You get the honor of being special in my heart. So please give some high cheers for drum roll. Please welcome someone who has been actively working together with the team to ensure that we have a lot of cultural exchange. And this someone is Ace, with a master's degree in high-tech entrepreneurship. Congratulations. The next person is from the same major. Please welcome Alba Garrido Martin, with a master's in high-tech entrepreneurship. Yes. The next person is with a master's degree in interaction design. Please welcome Alisa. Congratulations, Alisa. The next person is with a master's degree in high-tech entrepreneurship and presented their project today, Home for Nisha. Please congratulate Baymon. The next person is my brother from another mother, with a master's degree in digital marketing, my brother lookalike, Bilal. The next person in line with a master's degree in digital marketing, please congratulate Eagle. with a master's degree in digital marketing. Please congratulate Jessica. So I'm a. For the next person in line, my fellow Moroccan, please congratulate Iman for getting her master's degree in digital marketing. Woo! With a master's degree in digital marketing, please congratulate Winnie and her project, Heart from Home. Winnie, not only did she graduate this year, but she completed her internship with Big Green Corporate. With a master's degree in digital marketing, please welcome Louis from the Philippines. With a master's degree in interaction design, please congratulate Noel. Yes. And Noel is a bit sick, so let's hope he gets better. Not contagious, not COVID. By the way, this is not in order of GPA or anything. We just find a way to... Yes, I know. This is just in alphabetic order. With a master's degree in digital marketing, please congratulate Mahi from Ethiopia. So I... Of course. With a master's degree, yes, we should do this. Chris, take notes. We should do this. With a master's degree in digital marketing, the one and only, Marvin from the Philippines. Looking nice and sharp. The next in line, with a master's degree in digital marketing. This is someone who fought very, very hard to be here. Although they came very late, but they insisted on coming. Please congratulate Opeyami. from Nigeria. Yes. Yes. Congratulations for the new job as well. I saw your update on LinkedIn. Yes. Our next person could not be here, but since you are his friend, please congratulate Oscar with a master's degree in interaction design. He couldn't be here today, but Oscar, if you are watching this live, congratulations. Another interaction design student who couldn't be here, someone who we really like, and she always brings so much joy and jokes. Please, congratulations to Purnima. She's not here, but if you're watching, well done. Next person in line, please congratulate Piper with a master's degree in high-tech entrepreneurship. Per. So I'm Ma. Next person, our favorite, could be annoying, but we still like you and we still love you. Please, congratulations, C2, with a master's degree in high-tech entrepreneurship. I was hoping you sing this song before you ditched me, but he's not attending at the party. We'll deal with him. With a master's degree in interaction design, the fun of the party, Lily, please, congratulations. Woo! Sway Ma. With the next person in master's degree in interaction design, Lily's colleague, please congratulate Blessing. Next person is with a master's degree in interaction design still. Please congratulate Nunapa. Congratulations. Thank you.
she had been working on for a while. And oh my God, it's, you have to ask her for a video that Anthony made, and Anthony's here because he was so impressed with the final experience, digital experience that she made, that he came over here today, and he also came over to me like saying, what is going on in this school? You know, what do you do to them that they make things like that? Because his payment from Singapore went through seamlessly.
Congratulations, and please help me welcome to the stage with a master's degree in digital marketing, Soham from India. With a master's degree in interaction design. Today, I'm not sure if Natalie is here, but congratulations, Natalie. If you're watching this online, congratulations. I know that you're flying tomorrow to Barcelona, so have a safe trip. With a bachelor's degree in data science. Yes, today we have one bachelor that came from Barcelona and graduated here. They are not here today, but we want to give a shout out to Nicholas with a bachelor's in data science. With a master's degree in interaction design, please congratulate Paquin. With a master's degree in high-tech entrepreneurship, please congratulate Pilukmi. Coming from the corporate world and taking his classes sometimes from his very nice office, Pilukmi. With a master's degree in interaction design. This is someone that has been helping us a lot. I am not sure if she's here because she's supposed to arrive. She has a job already. So Per, congratulations for your master's degree in interaction design. Moving to a master's degree in digital marketing. Another person who is not here today, but congratulations, Lubna. Our next degree goes to a master's degree in interaction design, and this person is online, Mariam. Congratulations! Mariam is now in Barcelona to study another module of her choice. So congratulations, Mariam. We miss you. I miss you. With a master's degree in digital marketing, another Mariam from Morocco this time. Congratulations, Mariam Azhar. With a master's degree in interaction design, someone who just left last week back to Pakistan. Congratulations, Amar. Another fellow Moroccan. congratulations with a master's degree in digital marketing goes to Yusuf. He went to Malaysia.
Yes.
With a master's degree in data science. Please, congratulate Kultida. I know she's not here today. I'm not sure if she's back from Barcelona, but congratulations, Kultida. And one last person is with a master's degree in data science. He's Copcrit. He's someone who joined in my batch and has been here throughout this 2 years to finish his degree. So congratulations, Copcrit. I hope I didn't miss anyone. I didn't. All of you look beautiful with your scarves. Thank you all for joining here to give the certificates. If I can have Dr. Sawani for a moment. Yes, please. The president of Harbour.Space at UTCC would like to give you some words. Thank you.
Actually, it's just this date, among this time last year, that you were here for the orientation, preparing to be new students. And time flies. Already passed 1 year. Can you look back and compare you that day and you today on the path of laughter, tears, and hard working? You have experienced the changing, transforming from a freshie, not knowing much what's gonna happen during the year. But today, you are here and you present your projects with all the team behind all the projects. I am so proud of you, very proud. I am sure the world is waiting for you, for your contribution. So go for it. Make the difference to the world. And I be here, Ajahn Jay, Ajahn O, everyone, Svetlana, and all the teachers will still be here. Want to hear everything from you. More tears, more laughter, success, or give up, just come back. Okay, you promise, don't forget us here. So lastly, we would wish you all the best. Like you are like our family members. All the best happen to you. For the bright future, successful future, and always be good to the earth, to the world, to all the persons you be with. Congratulations.
Thank you, Dr. Salanin. Thank you so much. Now we are about to end today, to finish everything, but we still have some few fun things to show you and to acknowledge. So as a university, we had some individuals shining this year. individuals that not only contributed to their own personal growth, but also helped people around them and helped us as staff and helped everyone to have the best experience possible. So we have something called the Trajectory Award. This award is given to a student who really gave back not only to Harbour.Space, but to their community. And although we wanted to give this award to so many people here today, and we wanted to acknowledge everyone and each one of you, as I know, and as I'm very fully aware, there is a lot of you here, like Ace with the cultural projects, we have Marvin helping with events, we have a lot of you helping today, and Rico helping with Halloween party and everything, we could only choose one person, and I hope you all agree and see the significance. So please, welcome, Erin. Yes, I want to ask Irina, the Director of Academics, to give you this on behalf of our team, for always being there, helpful, and most importantly, kind to us. Thank you. I think Erin has some few words to share, not a speech.
Okay. Yes, yeah. First of all, thank you so much for choosing me to be part of this like wonderful honor award. I won't be here without all the support from every single one of you here who have contributed a lot in my life, and it's really transformed the way I am, made me who I am today. I was just like share a single thing, like I just throw back the day that I was like a new student last year. I was actually like just sit there at the back, like you guide the new student welcomes to this journey. That time I'm really confused whether is it right decision for me, like is it right, or am I will be able to survive this 1 year or not? Because there are so much many great people here, so many talented people here in this campus. I also throw back the time that I was before being a bachelor student. That time I really don't know what to do, where to go. I study math science. I'm studying normal Thai high school. I don't speak English. It's really hard. And that time I make a big decision in life, decided to join international college. I struggling a lot during this 3 to 6 months. But it turned out that I'm glad I have a right to make that decision. That's why it bring me to be here. And second time that I have a big decision that I need to make is when I join Harbour.Space. I'm also confused, like, should I do something else? Is this gonna worth my time? And it also turned out it's pretty amazing journey 1 year with these amazing peoples. And it's absolutely transformed who I was. That time I was dreaming I want to have a lot of foreigner friends. I dreaming I want to travel around the world. My dream, I just want to explore a lot of things. And it today, I'm really have a lot of these wonderful friends. I have a lot of great people behind. Professor, Silanas, Agenda Green, and many more who contribute to me. I'm really appreciate, and I would like to also dedicate this award to every single one of us here as well, because you guys work really hard. I'm really, really proud of you, and I know that in the future, you will even be a great and greater contribute to the best, to the world, to the society, to your community. And last but not least, I would like to leave this word for you. Be proud every day. Be proud of whatever you make in your decision you made in your life. And I'm sure you go somewhere that you never think before. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Ern. It has been an honor to witness your journey here, to witness you getting all this type of friendships and people from all over the world, to envy you when you were traveling to Switzerland and going to Barcelona and showcasing all these beautiful pictures on Instagram. So I'm so glad that you had the opportunity to live all of this during this 1 year and also contribute back, help us, and help your friends around you. Thank you so much, Ern. So there is one thing. Okay? There are three things left, and I'm sure you guys are very tired, but we have one more surprise, and it's not the next one. The next one is something very close to heart for me personally. As an alumna of Harbour Space, I studied first in Phuket because we didn't have this campus, and please be jealous, because we were in Phuket for 3 months. And during these 3 months, we had one master class of 1 week. This master class was very, very life-changing for me personally. I was seeking purpose when I first came here. And through this 1 week, I thought of things that I never could have imagined. So this 1 week master class was done with from one of the best digital marketers in the whole world. And trust me, you can search it up right now and Google him. This person was very inspiring to me. He just published one of his best-selling books. So I took the time, I sat down. We needed a commencement speech for the new journey of your life. And I thought about it couldn't be better than this person. He inspired me, and I wanted him to inspire you as well. So, this is a very busy man. Trust me, very, extremely busy, to the point that he has companies running, books selling, and talking in so many places. I know, Svetlana, you're curious who this person is. So I reached out to him via email, and he responded. This is a person I haven't spoken to for over a year. And this is my way of telling you that you can always stay connected to your mentors and your teachers. Please hear it from Mark Schaefer. You can Google him.
Hello to my friends at Harbour Space. And congratulations on this special day. You know, I get to know quite a few students around the world. My books are used as textbooks at more than 70 universities. But when I start talking about students around the world, I always say that the students at Harbour Space are my favorite. I always say that. But the reason might be something that is unexpected. Sure, you're smart, you're ambitious, many of you are even a lot of fun. But look, there are smart, ambitious, and fun students everywhere. The thing that I think distinguishes you is enthusiasm. I see it in your interactions in class, in the questions that you ask. I see it in the interactions you have with each other and how you work together on projects. And I want to tell you from a personal story why this is such an important quality. When I got out of college, my first job was with a big Fortune 100 company, but I had the worst job in the department. My job was to get to the office before 7 a.m. each day and go through business publications looking for news about our customers and our competitors and summarizing this in a document for executives before they got to work. Now, that doesn't sound too bad until you realize this was before the internet. This was before Google. I was literally looking through publications, but it gets worse. I didn't have any money, so I couldn't afford to park in the city. I had to park outside the city and walk about 20 minutes into work each morning in the freezing cold, and it was dark and I'd be the first one in the building, and I'd be all alone in the dark with the only office lit up to go through and create this summary. In my first performance review, my boss said, "You know, you have the worst job in the whole department, but you're doing great because you're always enthusiastic. When you're enthusiastic, you make the people around you better. Your enthusiasm spreads. It's contagious. You make people better colleagues, better team members, even better leaders." And he said, "Mark, this quality that you have of enthusiasm is going to serve you well throughout your life because it makes you special. It makes you different. And I think that's something that's special about you." And here's one of the things I learned. Sometimes, even when you do jobs that you don't like, even when you have the worst job in the department, sometimes you can kind of trick yourself and pretend to be enthusiastic. And if you pretend long enough, you kind of become enthusiastic. Leaders dispense hope. Even when you're doing a terrible job, even if you're in a time that might seem sort of bleak, leaders dispense hope. And that is especially important today. Congratulations to all of you. Go forward with enthusiasm and best wishes on your career journey.
I'm getting a lot of nostalgia. Thank you, Mark. If you're watching this, it has been an honor. And again, you can always reach out to your mentors, to your teachers. 1 year later and 2 years later, it doesn't matter because they know you and they know how much you're capable. One last thing from our side, I promise, is a surprise thing that we did for you guys. We created something for you as a thank you, as a celebration for your achievements. So, it's a final project, is it? Yes.
Desire.
Believe when I say I want it that way. That we are two worlds apart. We can't reach to your heart.
Falling apart from the way that I used to be. Yeah, no matter the distance, I want to know that deep down inside of me, you are my fire, the one desire. You are. Yeah.
I'm having tears in my eyes. Just, are you crying, Marvin? I'm crying too. It warms my heart to see that we've came so far. I love that you guys were able to make so many memories here. Not only studying, but a lot of fun events, a lot of joined moments, a lot of birthdays were celebrated here in your home, away from home. So today I am very, very touched by this, and I cannot believe that I will not see you on Monday. It feels surreal. We got so used to you so much, and we hope that you go and take with you the positive things and leave the negative things behind, because it's done and you're done, and you should move forward with a positive mindset. So thank you all. Thank you for today. I know that Ace wants to give few words to his friends, and I would like for Ace to come on stage. Ace, as you saw in the video, has been part of a lot of cultural events. He also organized many events as well, and through him we were able to know more about his culture, where he comes from, but also ask questions we never were brave enough to ask other people, because people here are with open mind and they always answer questions we are curious about. So Ace, please have some few words.
Thank you, Shema. Hello everyone. For those that don't know me, for this side of the audience, my name is Ace from Harbour.Space. I like how it rhymes so much. That's the sole reason why I chose to study here, by the way. It just rhymes, you know. I'm a high-tech entrepreneurship student, but I also did a minor in digital marketing here at Harbour.Space. So I'm very grateful to Harbour.Space for having me on a platform where I'm able to explore not just entrepreneurship, but marketing, especially in the digital realm. I just wanted to take this opportunity to say thank you to all of my friends here, the best ever students group from SCG. You've always been so nice to all of us. Thank you very much. Thank you to everybody else, my fellow high-tech entrepreneurs and my fellow students from digital marketing as well. You all, because I've taken 80 credits through this entire year, and I've been in touch and worked on so many projects with all of you. Thank you for having me in your projects. Thank you for being part of my project, Albert and Ace International. And for those that don't know Albert, that's my dad. He's sitting in the back over there. So finally, there's, you know, and we're putting a face to the name over there. And I just wanted to say thank you very much to the Harbour.Space staff. It was Shema actually last year. I remember exactly that moment. It was Chris, it was Kao, it was Shema, it was Mark, that I came here, and I still have a photo from that day. Maybe I'll leave it for the after party. But I remember asking Shema, should I be here? Does this place belong to me? Do I belong here? You know, and she just said, come with your project and you'll know. And that's, I just wanted to take a few seconds and say thank you to Shema. Thank you to the Harbour.Space staff. I think it goes underappreciated, but you guys do an amazing job. And a lot of times we don't express that enough. So thank you very much once again. Khopkun makmakap. And I will look forward to the party, guys. And with the dance moves.
And choreography,
yes. And one last thing is, we're not just taking back knowledge from Harbour.Space, we're taking the connections, the friendships, the memories that we've created. So don't forget that. And let's move forward together with that in mind. Thank you very much. Kapun kap.
Thank you, Ace. Thank you, everyone. Before we have our closing remarks from the president of UTCC, Dr. Associate Tanawat, Kun Tanawat, I'll only give a shout out to the rest of my team today for making today happen from 6 a.m. till now and for the after party. So please help me give a shout out to Miss Amanda, Miss Midday, Miss P-Jan, Miss Jan, PJ, Dingo here, our duo, Du and Wei, the technical team, the campus manager, Chris, Dingo here, and Mark, who left to prepare for the after party because we're going to dance. And for, of course, our guests here, Svetlana, and for everyone, I hope I didn't forget anyone. Besides Dr. Irina, thank you so much. And I am so proud to be part of such a hardworking team, and we always have each other's back. So thank you. Please, Kun, at you.
Thank you. Hello, everyone. Could you please applause for everybody in Harbour Space at UTCC? At first, officially, Achan Man, Dr. Sony Tyron-Rod, the president of Harbour Space at UTC, Svetlana, CEO of Harbour Space, and Kunim Kap, Lim Chu, Kunim, founder and like a shareholder of a Mayflower Corporation of Thailand, who is the co-founder of UTC, Harbour Space at UTC. Everybody, on behalf of UTC, I will be pleased to say congratulations to you. You know, at first, when I'm a vice president of UTC, in that time, CEO of UTC is Dr. Sony. And she talked with Svetlana and Kun Haralink and Professor Ingo. They say about change the world. This is the big vision of Harbour Space of Svetlana and UTC of Dr. Sony. In that time, I think it's a dream. But you know, the word that we send to UTCC students, we say that if you have a dream, follow your dream, ignite your passion, fuel your future, and then dream come true. Today is the living evidence that can prove that we can change the world. We can connect the world together. We can connect everybody in the world to do the good thing to the world. In my opinion, I know that you work really hard. Thank you very much for your work hard and work together to change something in the world and in this present time and in the future. For me, I think it's very good thing for Thai educational system as well, because Dr. Suni and I like to change the system of learning methodology. And Svetlana come to UTC, came UTC, and say, we're going to change it. We work together to change it. If you agree, please, we can. If you agree with that. Again, I know that it's very work. It's very hard work, because I see light all day and all night long. You can sleep here. You can work here all day and all night long. I know you are most exhausted. But today is proof that you're still happy. You still smile. I think you're happy to be here at Harbour Space, at UTC, at Harbour Space at UTC. And I learned that right now, you have a success today. And you get certificate from Harbour Space. And one day in the future, near future, you will get degree from UTC. In that time, you will prove to everybody, you will change the world. You change the learning system. Again, thank you very much. But before I end my speech, I'd like you again to give thanks to Harbour Space staff, Svetlana, Dr. Sony, and every lecturer and every staff. For me, on behalf of UTC, thank you very much to choose Harbour Space at UTC to be your partner. I think every memory, everything that you learn from Harbour Space at UTC is in your mind and in your memory. Thank you very much. Congratulations to all of you.
Kapuneka, Kuntanawat, Kapuneka, thank you for giving the closing ceremony for today. It's all. See, I keep my promises. This is it for us today. Thank you all for joining today, and thank you for your amazing performance for the people who presented today. I want to ask you for one last request. Please all join me on stage so we can have one final group picture. Yes, please. Thank you.
And one more thing while you're coming to the stage. We're going to make an executive decision that for all the graduates of Harbour.Space at UTCC, you guys can come back at any time you want for a module per year, whenever you want, so that, you know, you stay connected and you keep on learning, because that's what it is about, so that we can keep in touch.
Yes, please, everyone join me on stage, everyone. You can leave your boxes, just put the scarf and join me. Yes, after they come, I will invite the guests. Yes, for the guests, please join us also for the group picture. You were trying to run away. Just one quick picture, please. All of you. Airport, this way. Okay. Can we turn off? Chris, can we turn on the slides? So... A shout out for Jack. Please, for our guests of and investors and company representatives, please join. Where? Congratulations again, and see you in the after party. If you haven't registered for the after party, you can meet us there, and you can talk to Mark to register.